Hey, ABC, welcome to my crib. Come on through. So this is the dining area. I'm gonna be honest with you, I've never actually eaten at this table because it's unsanitary. Ideally, I wouldn't have to live like this. Or with these people.
First call out and away at 1 million. Like many millennials in Australia, I haven't got nearly enough cash to buy my own place. In fact, a global study found young Aussies are below average when it comes to owning a home. But in China, it's a very different story. A huge 70% of millennials aged 19 to 36 own their own home. It's one of the highest rates of home ownership for young people in the world. Music is in the 70%. She's a school teacher who bought an apartment in her hometown of Zhuhai back in 2019. It cost about 200,000 Australian dollars.
My budget was a million RMB, a million yuan. So I chose from those properties that is around this range. And then I chose the one with better location, even though the one I bought is small.
Traditionally, men are expected to provide a house when they get married in China, but you haven't waited for that. Are things changing now?
A lot of girls or boys at my age are already married. So for those married couples, they tend to buy an apartment. But for single persons like me, I think half-half, like half of us will buy apartments for investment, but half will just choose to spend money on other things or save it for the future.
Property in China is tied up to traditions around marriage. Parents often chip in or pay for a house entirely to increase their son's marriage prospects. A worthy investment since parents are very likely going to move in with their son when they retire. But couples in China have had a huge advantage when it comes to buying property, because two sets of parents to juice money out of is way better than one. The CCP, alarmed by the increasingly heating property market, started to make it really hard for couples to buy multiple properties.
They wanted to cap the number of properties a family could own and post restrictions on loans. These are to cool down the overheated housing market and to prioritize first-time buyers.
And when couples around China realised their dreams of a property empire were over, they all got divorced. Well, only temporarily.
A number of couples, they fake their divorces in order to purchase more properties with a cheaper rate as first-time buyers.
And once they bought their new properties, they'd simply get remarried. And the problem isn't limited to big cities. Last year, police in the Zhejiang province arrested 11 members of an extended family who married and divorced each other 23 times in 2 weeks to cash in on an urban renewal project.
Meanwhile, in Australia, I can't find a single person who will marry me even once. Hey you, would you marry me?
Crack off.
Fair enough.
Other popular ways to cheat the system include paying a friend or relative to put property in their name, obtaining a different ID in a maiden name,
or just getting a completely fake ID.
The loopholes, however, are likely to continue as the government engages in a giant game of whack-a-mole with its citizens, who come up with endlessly creative workarounds. Speaking of workarounds, I reckon I've got an idea.
All right, everyone, it's now or never. Let's pool our money and buy a house. What have we got? All right, luckily I got paid last night, so here's my contribution.